Tim.
It's the morning star drive 117.8. You soaring up with sky, now's the time, don't delay. I'm sitting in my ride and it's time to fly. So let's realign, just listen and fill your mind.
I'm burning with desire and the passion. Nobody can stop me when I'm like this. I got my head in the zone, you know. I'm on the morning star drive, you know.
Hey guys, how's it going? It's Wednesday, January 19th, and this is the Morningstar Drive on 117.8. We're on YouTube, so make sure to subscribe, follow us on SoundCloud, and make sure to support us on Patreon. So what is happening on this wonderful Wednesday? We've got coronavirus updates, current news from around the world, realizing from the Tuesday Proverbs, and of course, every Wednesday we have Danny's Money with Daniel Baker from Korea. All right, everyone, how are you doing? It is the middle of the week. It is hump day, and I hope you guys are enjoying it. And even more than this, we have a Wednesday service tonight, and our leaders are preaching. So I really hope that you guys can encourage them and pray for them so they can preach a powerful message coming from the Holy Spirit. I just want to remind everyone to keep liking and commenting. I want to hear from you guys and see how you're doing. Write your questions, requests, testimonies, feedback. What we're trying to do is build the community. Yes, on SoundCloud, too, you can leave likes and comments, too. And I'm responding on both platforms, all right? So it's already Wednesday. And like I said before, when we have our leaders preaching, and this is something that's Sunseam has entrusted our leaders even more these days. Every Wednesday we have our preachers, our head leaders and assistant leaders all preaching. And I really hope that you guys pray for them. This is not an easy thing. Right? Because it's the words of God that they didn't receive themselves, it's much harder to preach with that fire in Shimjung. So we really need to pray for our head leaders and make sure that that Shimjung of the Lord comes out. Okay? And we have, you know, it's even better for us because when our preachers preach powerfully, then we feel it better. Then we'll realize better. And on top of that, we'll be able to take action much better too, right? So everyone, please pray for your leaders, for today's sermon, everything else. And, you know, I'm just really thankful and grateful that the Lord and the Holy Trinity has entrusted our leaders with preaching the amazing words of God. And I hope that all of us here too will prepare ourselves, pray not just for the head leaders, but pray for ourselves. As Sunseam said, we need to realize about what joy is, okay? I put out my YouTube short yesterday and great response. It's like the fastest response I've had. YouTube short. Yeah, I did YouTube shorts and also my IG Reels. IG Reels seems to be a lot more popular than the YouTube shorts, but both of them are probably the best short that we had is my mom interrupting a word study. So thank you for all your likes and all your comments. It's hilarious, by the way. And you know what the funny thing is? My mom, like, I showed her first because, you know, I didn't want to put it up without my mom knowing because she watches all my YouTube videos. And she watched it and she's like, oh, no, I'm so embarrassed. But then she's laughing at the same time. But you know what the funny thing she said next was? She says, hey, don't leave me like this. So make another video when I'm all done up in my makeup and pretty. So I was like, I was laughing, but I was like, you know what, mom? Of course I'll do that for you, making sure that you look your prettiest and you're going to be on this YouTube channel too. So I had a good laugh with that also. But you know, it's our parents. We don't want them to leave the social media world looking like that in her pajamas. We need to make her look like her best and making sure that she knows that, yes, I'm going to tell her I love her regardless of how she looks, but you know, for her sanity and for her safety, her peace in her heart, I'm going to have to make another YouTube short where she looks the prettiest, right? And of course, you know, today is the 19th, which means tomorrow is her birthday. She's turning 70. So super crazy and happy, thankful that I'm able to be here for that birthday too. All right. On Espresso with Sky, on that channel too, tomorrow we're going to have a video is why does God make it so hard to believe in him? You know, he's invisible. We can't see him. We can't hear him. There's a lot of different things that we can't do. And then God just expects everyone to believe. So why is it so hard to believe? All right. And remember this week's Sunday edition, we met Dora Lorencia from Malaysia. And be sure to catch that interview. And next week's Sunday edition, we're going to go to Houston, I believe. We're going to Houston, Texas, and we're going to meet Prince, right? Prince Givens, Prince Givens. And I was really fortunate to meet him over the last couple of years. And I didn't realize this, but I taught him when he was like a newcomer too, when I was over there in Houston also. Love this guy. He's amazing. Him and I, we were playing sports in Houston when I went down there. And of course, we had to win the last game of the day. So I was super happy about that. But yeah, Prince, we're going to meet him. He's really, really young and fiery. And I really hope you guys can watch that next week's Sunday edition too, right? So this week is Malaysia Dora. She's Indonesian, evangelized and running in Malaysia. And then we have Prince Givens, and he's from Houston, Texas. That'll be next week's Sunday edition. So hope you guys will really enjoy that. And you know what? Prince is someone you can say he's running with joy. He really, really is. Either way. But the one thing I hold against him, he's a vegetarian. He's a vegetarian. No! But the good thing is that I can eat all the meat when we go to barbecues and stuff like that. But either way. So let's get into today's featured artist of the day. We're going to take a look at some member artists. And we have a new member artist today. Oh, man. I got sent this last night. Amazing. I couldn't believe. You guys know the Rapture Collective from Australia. One of them, Daniel Patterson. You guys got to listen to this. From the Rapture Collective, he has a solo song that he just produced and recorded himself. His MC name is MC One Love. This song is called The Journey. Great song. I can't believe the quality of this producing and mixing. And basically this song, it's a rap about the story of his journey he took from the world to Christianity and then to Providence. And everything is made and produced by himself. So everyone, please welcome MC One Love from Australia with The Journey. Second song will be Kuma Chung from Japan with Hero Second featuring Taru. And then last but not least, we have PGY from the Paper Music Associates in Korea with Wherever. All right. So let's make sure that we, as we're praying each and every morning, we cheer on these member artists from around the world.
Promises coming to fruition, rising take up to a higher level. You can hear it in the bass, you can hear it in the treble. I was blind but now I see, I was living without hope. At the end of my rope, the sound is so dope. I met the Lord's history, purpose ain't a mystery. I was blind but now I see, I was living without hope. At the end of my rope, the sound is so dope. I met the Lord's history, purpose ain't a mystery.
머리를 울리는 당신의 외침이 들려. 않는다고 없는 게 아니니까 아무리 어두워도 내일은 오니까 태양의 등불은 어디에나 있어줄게 그러니 울지 마
PGY from PMA in Korea with Wherever. Before that, Kumachang from Japan with Hero the Second featuring Taru. And of course, brand new debut MC One Love. That is Daniel Patterson over there from Australia. One of the four from the Rapture Collective. That song is The Journey. Amazing, awesome, deep song about his journey from the world to Christianity and then into Providence. So mixed and produced all by himself. Awesome job. Thank you so much, Daniel, for sharing that with us. I'm sure we're going to be playing that a lot too. And keep making music, guys. We got so many talented member artists from around the world. And all we want to do is share this love and all this talent that we have, right? So let's get into the news for today. And of course, the top three reasons why we have this news. Because Sunseem said, number one is, through the world news, you can see what God is doing. Number two, we're able to see the condition of the world. And of course, last but not least, these sad and depressing stories. You know, it's even more sad and depressing for God who created all these people. And this is why, after listening to this news, we need to be those that comfort God's heart. Okay, so let's get into the coronavirus updates for today. In the world, there have been 332.2 million cases to date for the coronavirus and over 5.56 million deaths. But once again, great news again, mortality rate has dropped down to 1.67%, down 0.01% from the day before. Top five countries going by daily death rates. We start off with Russia, 670 deaths with 30,000 cases. US in second with 468 deaths and 389,000 cases. India, 302 deaths with 238,000 cases. France, 296 deaths with 102,000 cases. And of course, Italy, 287 deaths with 83,000 cases. Great news is deaths are down all across the board, and that's why we are seeing the mortality rate continuously dropping lower and lower. Over here in North America, of course, the U.S. is on top. And then Canada in second with 149 deaths with 23,000 cases. And then Mexico, 76 deaths with 19,000 cases. All right, so let's get into the current news going around the world. We'll start off with the top three news in the U.S., right? So U.S. airlines are warning of impending 5G flight disruption. Now, what does that mean, 5G? We're talking about 5G internet. The 10 biggest U.S. airlines have warned that the impending switch on of 5G mobile phone services will cause major disruption to flights. They said the start of Verizon and AT&T 5G mobile phone services planned for Wednesday would cause a completely avoidable economic calamity. Airlines fear C-band 5G signals would disrupt planes' navigation systems, particularly those used in bad weather. The warning was issued in a letter sent to U.S. aviation authorities. The chief executives of American Airlines, Delta, and United were joined by others in saying immediate intervention is needed to avoid significant operational disruption to air passengers, shippers, supply chain, and delivery of needed medical supplies, including vaccine distribution. The BBC has seen the letter outlining their urgent concerns, and it was sent to Transportation Secretary Pete Buttigieg, as well as the head of the Federal Aviation Administration, the chair of the Federal Communications Commission, and the director of the National Economic Council. The BBC understands that negotiations are continuing at the highest levels of the U.S. government about what has been described as a very fluid situation. Now, the airlines want 5G signals to be excluded from the approximate 2 miles of airport runways at affected airports as defined by the FAA on January 19, 2022. These concerns were recently highlighted by the two big plane makers, Airbus and Boeing, in a rare joint warning. The group of airlines said airplane manufacturers have informed us that there are huge swaths of the operating fleet that may need to be indefinitely grounded. So in an update on Sunday, the FAA, which oversees aviation safety across the U.S., said it had cleared an estimated 45% of the U.S. commercial fleet to perform low visibility landings at many of the airports where 5G C-band will be deployed. Now, the FAA added that it had approved two radio altimeter models that are installed in a wide variety of Boeing and Airbus planes. Phone companies have spent tens of billions of dollars on upgrading their networks to deploy the 5G technology, which brings much faster internet services and greater connectivity. Now, there have been several delays already because of the aviation concerns, with launch dates in December and earlier this month both being pushed back. U.S. wireless industry group CTIA has previously said 5G is safe and accused the aviation industry of fear-mongering and distorting facts. So let's see what's going to happen here, but we're hoping that nothing of that calamity will actually happen, okay? In second news, we're going to go back to Tonga, and scientists are warning that Tonga eruptions may damage environment for years. So satellite imagery suggests the eruption of Hunga Tonga Hunga Ha'apai could cause long-lasting environmental damage. The huge volcanic eruption in the Pacific Island nation of Tonga could cause long-lasting damage to coral reefs, erode coastlines, and disrupt fisheries, and scientists studying satellite imagery have warned. Now, Hunga Tonga Hunga Ha'apai, an undersea volcano, erupted on Saturday, triggering tsunami warnings across the Pacific in the first official update. Tonga's government on Tuesday said multiple people have been injured and three have died. The eruption has been releasing sulfur dioxide and nitrogen oxide, two gases that create acid rain when they interact with water and oxygen in the atmosphere. And we all know that acid rain causes widespread crop damage and could affect Tongan staples such as taro, corn, bananas, and garden vegetables. So depending on how long the eruptions last, food security could be compromised. Now, satellite imagery suggests the plume is spreading westwards, which means Tonga could be spared some of the acid rain at the expense of Fiji. The United Nations Humanitarian Affairs Office said Fiji was monitoring its air quality and has advised people to cover their household water tanks and stay indoors in the event of rain. Now, falling ash could also damage coral reefs, which were already under threat before the eruption. There's Tom Shills, a marine biologist at the University of Guam, said vast areas of the reefs in the immediate impact area at Hunga Tonga are probably buried and smothered by large deposits of volcanic ash. Now, eruptions such as the one on Saturday also release more iron into the water, which can boost the growth of blue-green algae and sponges that further degrade reefs. Now, while scientists have yet to investigate on the ground, available satellite imagery shows a blanket of ash on land. In the ocean, ash can be harmful to marine life, according to the Tonga Geological Services, which has warned that nearby seawater was contaminated with toxic volcanic discharge and that fishermen should assume fish in these waters are poisoned or poisonous. So, Tonga is home to about 100,000 people and has 170 islands, in which 36 are inhabited. As most Tongans rely on the ocean for their food and livelihoods, scientists have warned of fish perishing or migrating following the eruption. So that is a lot of prayers out to Tonga and all the people who have families over there too. Last but not least, last in the news for the world news, we're going to go to the UK. And UK, the Ukraine, and Canada. And what has happened? The UK has given the Ukraine anti-tank weapons, and Canada sends special forces. So moves come as Russia denies U.S. claims that it's looking for a pretext to invade the Ukraine. The UK has begun supplying Ukraine with anti-tank weapons, and Canada has reportedly deployed a small contingent of special forces to Kiev amid concerns of a possible invasion by Russia. The developments came as Russian Foreign Minister Sergei Lavrov angrily rejected claims by the United States last week that Moscow was preparing a pretext to invade Ukraine if diplomacy failed to meet its objectives. Now, while Moscow, which has deployed 100,000 troops near its border with Ukraine, denies plans for an attack against the Ukraine and has said it could take unspecified military action unless the West agrees to a list of demands, including banning Kiev from ever joining NATO. Now, Russia views NATO's expansion eastwards as an existential threat, but Washington and its allies have firmly rejected Moscow's demands and Russia-US negotiations in Geneva and a related NATO-Russia meeting in Brussels ended last week without a breakthrough. Kiev has since asked Western countries for arms to help it protect itself. And speaking in the British Parliament on Monday, Defense Secretary Ben Wallace said the UK had taken the decision to supply Ukraine with light anti-armor defensive weapon systems. The first weaponry was delivered on Monday, and a small number of British personnel would provide training for a short period of time, he said, without specifying the number and type of weapons that were being sent. In Kiev, Ukraine's defense minister, Oleksiy Reznikov, welcomed the UK support, saying in a Twitter post that his country highly appreciates Britain's decision to provide a new security package with light anti-armor defensive weapon systems. Now, Ukrainian officials have warned that Russia could launch an attack on their country from various directions, including from the territory of its ally, Belarus. Russian and Belarusian troops are planning to hold large-scale military drills next month, including near Belarus's border with the Ukraine. Belarus Security Council Secretary Alexander Volfovich said on Monday that Russian troops had started arriving in the country for the exercise, according to the Belta News Agency. Now, in addition to denying having plans to attack its neighbor, Russia has instead accused the Ukrainian leadership of hatching plans to use force to reclaim control of the Russian-backed rebel-held territories in eastern Ukraine. Ukrainian authorities have denied the claim. Now, separately in Canada, Global News reported that Ottawa had dispatched special forces operators to the Ukraine. Citing unspecified sources, the TV broadcaster said the unit will identify ways to assist the Ukrainian government and help develop evacuation plans for Canadian diplomatic personnel in the event of a full-scale invasion. Now, a spokesperson for the Canadian Special Operations Forces Command said it could not confirm the report, but said it has supported the Ukrainian security forces on a periodic basis to provide training and instructor and leadership expertise since 2020. No, the report came as Canadian Foreign Minister Melanie Joly met Ukrainian Prime Minister Denis Shmigal in Kiev on Monday during a visit aimed at discussing efforts to deter aggressive actions by Russia. All right, so that is a top three news going around the world. Hopefully, there's not going to be some invasion by Russia into the Ukraine. So let's just hope things are going to work out there. So let's get into the sporting news. NFL wildcard weekend, last game of the weekend, huge one. Number four, the LA Rams against number five, Arizona Cardinals. And guess what? The LA Rams crushed the Cardinals 34-11. It was already 21-0 after the first quarter. It was a blowout and giving Matthew Stafford his first playoff win in 12 seasons. And they're going to face Tom Brady and the defending champion Buccaneers on Sunday in Tampa Bay, Florida. In NBA news, a lot of games on the slate. We had Boston defeating the New Orleans Pelicans 104-92. Charlotte Hornets defeat the New York Knicks 97-87. Miles Bridges with 38 points, 12 rebounds, 5 assists. Washington defeats Philadelphia 117-98. Joel Embiid in a losing effort with 32 points and 8 assists. Cleveland beats the Brooklyn Nets 114-107. They lost Kevin Durant to injury. Memphis defeats Chicago 119-106. So even though they lost a game, they're back on track to winning again. The Memphis Grizzlies. The Clippers defeat the Indiana Pacers 139-133. Atlanta beats the defending champions Milwaukee Bucks 121-114. Trae Young with 30 points and 11 assists. Portland Trailblazers beat the Orlando Magic 98-88. Miami defeats the Toronto Raptors 104-99. Jimmy Butler with a triple-double, 19 points, 10 rebounds, and 10 assists. And then Phoenix, number one team in the league, defeat the San Antonio Spurs 121-107. Devin Booker with 48 points, 5 rebounds, 6 assists. Dallas Mavericks defeat the OKC Thunder 104-102. Luka Doncic, another triple-double, 20 points, 11 rebounds, 12 assists. And the LA Lakers defeat the Utah Jazz 101-95. They're now sitting pretty at 500. LeBron James, 25 points, 7 rebounds, and 7 assists. And last in sporting news, we have the Australian Open, this big tennis tournament that had that huge scar of Novak Djokovic being kicked out of Australia for not being vaccinated. In men's, you have Australia's own Nick Kyrgios defeats Liam Brody in 3-0, 3-0. Medvedev defeats Laxinen in 3-0. Andy Murray comes back, and he used to be like number one from England, and he defeats Basilashvili in 5 sets. And Rafael Nadal is also going to be playing in the night, right? In women's, number one, Ashley Barty defeats Lysia Cyrenko. Straight sets. There were some upsets here. Angelique Kerber, number 16, loses to unseeded Kaya Kanepi, 6-4, 6-3. And the Canadian Leila Fernandez, she's the one that went to the finals for the U.S. Open, and she's ranked 23rd, and she loses to unseeded Madison Inglis. But Emma Raducanu, who is the U.S. Open champion that did beat Leila Fernandez from the U.K., she defeats Sloane Stephens 2-1. All right. So that's the top three news for sports, top three news for top three world news, and of course, the coronavirus updates for today. All right. So let's get into the golden time, a time of praise and worship to the Holy Trinity. We're going to start off with Go Higher and Higher, and then Starting Point of the Will, and then we'll end things off with a much needed song of praise. It is Prayer is Work. So as one body of the Morning Star Drive, let's spend this time giving praise, honor, and glory to the Holy Trinity.
Look at you. You are dazzling, led by the Holy Spirit. You are changing in the best way. Look at me. I'm dazzling, led by the word of truth. I know my destiny is changing. Go higher and higher, while throwing out my thoughts. Go higher and higher, taking action on His will. Go higher and higher, beyond the limit. That's how I can really truly love myself in the best way. We are, we are, we are, we are transformed. We are, we are, we are awesome for sure. Let's climb the highest heights. Go higher.
And just keep going.
Transforming, awesomeing, go higher. Na na na, na 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 na.
Yeah.
Look at you, look at me. Everyone is shining, dazzling. Walls that block you and me with the Lord right through them. When we can do no more, the secret is do one more. There are no limits here, we're not with no limit. Don't stop, it just keep going. You changed a lot, so gotta keep growing. Started from the bottom, now we're going to the highest. The Lord, he takes me to the Trinity.
Rise up on the rest,
go high.
Changing for the best,
go high.
Rise up on the rest,
go high.
Changing for the best,
go high.
Rise up on the rest,
go high.
Changing for the best,
go high.
Rise up on the rest,
go high.
Transforming, awesomely,
go high.
Go higher and higher, while throwing out the thoughts. Go higher and higher, taking action on his will. Go higher and higher, beyond the limit. That's how I can really truly love myself in the best way. For sure. Let's climb the highest heights. Go higher and higher.
Don't stop and just keep going.
Transforming, awesome me.
Go high.
We are, we are, we are, we are transformed. We are, we are, we are awesome for sure. Let's climb the highest heights. Go higher and higher.
Don't stop and just keep going.
Transforming, awesome me.
Go high.
Just as things get done when you make out. what you ask will be granted. If your prayers meet God's heart, you should pray not just for yourself, but pray for your brothers, nation, and world. Pray sincerely, pray daily. It's the work you must surely do.
is prayer is work, and it is something we really, really need to do right now. Before that, starting point of the will, and of course, go higher and higher. All right, so I'm glad you guys enjoyed that time of praise and worship to the Holy Trinity, which means it leads us into today's word study. Yes, super duper happy about today's word study. We're going to go into the Tuesday Proverbs once again, and now that the 15 days of GGG are over, we can get back into our regular schedule, and on top of that, we're able to look at these deep Proverbs about prayer, okay? Prayer, giving thanks, and realizing, all right? So let's start off with the first proverb for today. It says, give thanks after you have realized. Giving thanks without realizing is like a blind person saying that something exists even though he has not actually seen it. Now, what does it mean? Giving thanks, you have to give thanks after you've realized. And it reminded me of a kind of a situation that all of us have to think about, okay? So there was a, before I left Los Angeles, because in Los Angeles before I came here, I was there almost until Christmas. And what happened was I left my uncle and aunt a card, right? Like maybe 3 days before I left. And I said, hey, Merry Christmas. Thank you so much for having me here. I was there for like 4 months, right? So I left the card for them like, oh, thank you so much. Merry Christmas. And it kind of ended there, right? And it was only like, you know, so they said thank you, but they didn't know what was, you know, what I actually gave them, right? And later when they saw what I gave them, they came back again in sincerity, because they know exactly what I gave them. Like, I bought them a new patio set for their new patio that they just built, and they were just like, oh my goodness, and they were so thankful. So it's like, the difference was when they gave thanks without knowing what it was. It's like a blind person. They were blind. They have no idea, right? And they've never seen it. But then after I showed it, after they opened it and saw it, they were more joyful, more sincere, and they were thankful. So there is a big difference of getting a gift and thanking them after you've seen it and when you haven't seen it. And that's the difference between realizing and not realizing, when you finally understand what you actually got, right? And I think that for us too, we have to really have that realization of what did we really get, right? More than anything else. Okay. Now, number two says to give thanks after realizing means to give thanks after clearly understanding that God saved you and helped you. And this is something that we have, that Sunseem talks about a lot, is what is, 1 second, my nose is running. Okay, so the question that Sunseem always says, what is the one thing you should be praying and thanking God about every single day, no matter what? Right? And that is salvation and the rapture, right? That is the ultimate thing. The greatest thing that God has done for you are those two things. And this is why to realize, right, to give thanks after realizing, which means you have to clearly understand the highest and greatest thing that God has done for us is not, you know, getting that food after you prayed for it, getting clothes, or someone bought you a car, or you even got a house, and you're like, whoa, these are such huge things. No, he says the ultimate thing is that God saved you and helped you, right? It is salvation and the rapture. And how did God do this? Well, when you look at salvation and the rapture, it was all done through the conditions of the Lord, right? Everything was done in this way. And we need to also give thanks after realizing, which means salvation, the rapture. Wow, this is the ultimate thing that we should be thanking God so much in our prayers every single day. God, we are so grateful and thankful that you have saved us from death. Without this, all these toys and cars and clothes and food means absolutely nothing. Thank you so much. And then even more, thank you for the rapture. And we have to realize this more deeply than anything else. Now, the next five Proverbs are very interesting because they have a very similar theme, right? Like, what does it mean to realize? Well, you know, they gives you a lot of analogies of what it means to really realize something clearly, right? So let's take a look at these from 3 to 7. So 3 says, having realized is like knowing clearly who gave you the large amount of money or goods you received. And this makes a big difference because who you got it from makes a difference. Like, I'm going to give you an example to everyone here right now is if someone gives you, like, say, a cheap watch. Someone gives you a cheap watch, okay? And you're like, oh, thank you. It's a cheap watch. message, right? And you, but you don't know who gave it to you. But imagine later you find out, oh, guess what? Sunsneam gave you that watch. You'd be like, whoa, my goodness, right? And it changes the way that you look at the gift, because what one thing that we know is that who gives it to you creates meaning in what you get, right? So what is it? Having realized is knowing clearly who gave you the money or the goods you received, even if it's large or small, right? Yeah, if Pastor John or something gives it to you, it's different. The fourth one, number four says, after previously only having a vague notion that many people were helping you, you can only say you've realized when you absolutely know and believe that it was God who helped you through people, right? So the key point here is we do give thanks to God all the time, but it's you absolutely know and believe it was God who helped you. Absolutely, clearly, right? That is people who really realized. It is absolute knowledge. No, this was not a person. It was God who did this for me. And you have to believe it. Not just say it like we say all the time. You know, a lot of times, you know, we're going to say it with our lips. Wow, God, I'm so thankful, God, you did this for me. But we need to truly, absolutely believe it more than anything else. Number five says, realizing is like this. A sick person did not know why he was ill, but after he went to the hospital for an examination, clearly found out he has cancer. Only then can it be said he has realized. This realization is talking about clearly understanding, like absolute 100%. And this is what God wants from us. Absolute, undeniable, that faith that is unshaking, knowing clearly no matter what anyone says. And this is something that has to do with this never shaking heart, especially when I'm looking at myself too. Looking at all these people talking like bad rumors about me, you know, things that happened 17 years ago. If it shakes my heart, then I haven't realized clearly, right? I have to be that absolute more than anything else, that no matter what anyone says, I can defend the Lord. I can defend this history. Number six says, realizing is like knowing that the other person is lying to you, and thus you are not deceived, right? And when we realize, what does that mean? When you absolutely realize this history, people are going to say many things, and people might even bring up slander to you. They might even say, I saw it with my own eyes. But if you realize, you know they're lying. That's right, you know. And one thing that we don't want is when people haven't realized deeply yet and they hear and see slander and then they get shaken by it. We have to be those says, no, we will not be like this, right? We understand and realize so clearly this is absolute false, right? And this is the crazy thing. When you look at like even the trial that Sunsneam went through, at the end of it, when you see what happens in the end, this is when you know like, oh my gosh, I shouldn't have shaken before, because look at all this, all the evidence starts to come out that it was untrue. The last one from 3 to 7 that talks about what is, you know, the analogies of what realization is those who have not realized are like those enjoying a certain food very much, but don't know what kind of food it is. Now, what does that mean? Like, for me, I was like, well, is that really a big deal? But, you know, I think we felt that this is an experience I've had before. I'm not sure if you've had it before. Is don't you love it? Like, you go to a restaurant, you go to some place, someone brings some food over. It's like, oh, dude, you got to try this, so good. And you taste it like, oh, my goodness, this is so amazing. And then you're like, man, I want, and the next day or the next week, you want to go get that food. But you're like, what was that? And you're really like itching for this food, like what did I eat, right? And even if you find the restaurant, you're still looking like, man, what was I eating? What was that thing that was so good? What did I order? But you're not sure what it is, right? So those that are, you know, those that have realized, or those who don't realize, are those that eat that food, right? And they enjoy it so much, but they have no idea what it is, right? They have no idea what it is. Right, they can't say, oh, this was the best baklava, this was the best haggis, this was the best, you know, borscht. Like, you know, there's like so many different, like, but people would say, what is borscht? And you're like, I don't know, what's haggis? And you know, I'm like, you don't want to know what haggis is, but it's like, what is that? But you just eat it and it's good, right? And we have to clearly know truth. And it's about, do we clearly know? Like, when it comes to truth, do we just know it in our heads? Like, oh yeah, this is the truth. But then we don't know anything about the word. You know what I mean? You know it's good because you felt it, but you can't even explain it to anyone. You don't clearly know, right? And that's when you think about that here, it's like, oh, that makes a bit more sense. Yeah, there are many things that I believe, but I never research it. I don't even go into it. And I just believe it because it's the words of God and I felt it. But people are going to ask, why do you believe? Are you believing blindly or not? You have to clearly know. I'm enjoying this food. Remember, food is a parable for the word. You enjoy this food so much, but you don't know what kind of food it is, right? And we have to be those that clearly know the food of the word, and not only know the word, but know exactly what we're eating or what we're teaching people to, okay? So that was 3-7 talking about what is realizing like. And that leads to number 8, pray after realizing. Then you will pray with correct understanding. So the key word here is correct understanding, right? That's the thing. If you pray before realizing, you won't understand correctly. So what kind of example can we give about this? What does it mean to pray with incorrect understanding? Imagine you tell someone thank you, or you're telling someone about a subject, but you don't know it correctly. Right? So then you're telling this person the incorrect thing. Or this person that knows the truth is going to look at you like, man, this person's crazy. Why are they thinking this? And it's like sometimes we give thanks to God for something totally doesn't make sense. Or maybe it wasn't even God who did that, right? Or maybe you're like, oh, God, oh, I think my thinking is right. Oh, I realize this thing here. But God's like, no, I didn't tell you that. And we start praying things that don't even make sense. We pray things that are wrong. How could God answer that type of prayer when we haven't even realized correctly yet? And this is why we have to pray after realizing, and then with correct understanding, we can talk to God properly, where God knows absolute truth. So I hope that's something that we can understand too, is it doesn't mean don't pray about a subject, but you should pray about it, asking for wisdom, asking that's why Sussim's saying, pray to realize what joy is. What is joy? And when you realize that joy, you'll be like, that is what I was thinking about. That's what I was talking about, right? Oh, this is what, and you can pray about it more deeply with God. Number 9 and 10 also have talk about the value of realization. How valuable is realization, right? These two. Number 9 says, only those who have realized know the value. Catch opportunities without missing them. Take action with correct understanding and thus gain things to enjoy. As a result, their lives are full of satisfaction and thanksgiving. So the big question here, it's an answer to how do I live a life of satisfaction and thanksgiving? How can I live that type of life where I'm so satisfied with my life and I'm so thankful? Is you have to realize, right? When you realize, what are the four things that happen when you realize? Well, these are the four things that are needed to live a life of satisfaction and thanksgiving. Number one is to know the value. Number two is to be able to grab opportunities without missing them. Number three is to take action with the correct understanding, because if you do that, you'll make the correct actions. And last but not least is gain things to enjoy, right? So this is when we live a life of satisfaction and thanksgiving, and that's why realizing is so valuable. You gain those four things, but the most important part of if you realize, you will live a life of satisfaction and thanksgiving. Number 10 also talks about the value of realization too. Only those who have realized value what they've gained. Things turn out well for them, so everyone realize and take action right away, right? So remember one thing again, it says only those who have realized value what they've gained, right? So whether it's the rocks where Sunseem found, remember he found the rocks among the discarded rocks. He found rocks that he bought like 22 years ago for like $500. And then when he finally realized, oh, this is what I got. And this is when things turn out well for them, right? Because imagine he just sells those things that are worth like hundreds of thousands of dollars. What if that's the thing that God was helping you with when you're saying, God, I'm losing my payments. I can't pay for this or this or this. And then God says, it's among you. Look for what you already have. And you have a rock there that you could sell for hundreds of thousands of dollars. And then you could pay off all your bills. But then you give it away because you don't know how valuable it really is, right? So only those who have realized value what they've gained, and then things will turn out well. So realize and take action, okay? And the last proverb for today is, those who have not realized have not found the problem yet. And this is something that I thought about when it came to ministry. Sussim said during the Western GGG that if you keep continuing to do ministry the way you are now, there is no hope. Which means what? It means that if we have not realized about ministry, we can't see the problem. And if we don't see the problem, we're not going to solve it, and we're always going to have bad ministry, right? We're not going to evangelize a lot. We keep doing things the same way, and we always make the same mistakes. We just feel like we have to do it this way because that's the way we've always done it, and we never catch the actual problem we need to solve. If we don't realize, right, then we haven't found the problem. Because when you realize, like, oh, this is what we should be doing. Wait, that means what we've been doing is wrong. This is the problem that we have. And for us too, whether it's structure, organization in your church, whether it's yourself, we have to realize. Because once you realize, you find the problem. And I think that is something that is very important for all of us here, is we need to catch and find the problem. But the big problem is we don't know what the problem, we haven't realized, so we can't figure out that problem, all right? So that is the word study for today. I hope that you guys really enjoyed. I enjoy these Tuesday Proverbs. It's like another pre-dump we're having today. So I hope you guys really, really enjoyed it more than anything else. All right. So that is the word study for today, on today's Wednesday podcast, which means we're going to go into the song of choice for today. And I'm going to go way back into time, a song way back in 1983. Those of you guys, I need to kind of educate and culture you guys when it comes to old music, the good music. We're going to go back to 1983, Billy Joel, and this is a song, Just the Way You Are. Hope you guys really enjoy it.
Don't go changing to try and please me. You never let me down before. Mm-hmm. Don't imagine you're too familiar, and I don't see you anymore. I would not leave you in times of trouble. We never could have come this far. Mm-hmm. I took the good times, I'll take the bad times, take you just the way you are. Don't go trying some new fashion. Don't change the color of your hair. Mm-hmm. You always have my unspoken passion. I might not seem to care. I don't want clever conversation. Never want to work that hard. Mm-hmm. I just want someone that I can talk to. I want you just the way you are. Someone that I knew. Oh, what will it take till you believe in me the way that I believe in you? I said I love you, that's forever. This I promise from the heart. I couldn't love you any better. I love you just the way you are. Wait. Thank you. someone that I can talk to. I want you just the way you are.
Go. That is Billy Joel. Way back in 1983, I was only 5 years old at this time. This is Just the Way You Are. What a smooth song. He is still popular in the world, still doing concerts. He is amazing. There's a bunch of other songs I really love for him. One of my favorites is Piano Man, but hope you guys really enjoyed that. Okay, so that is a song of choice for today, which means we're going to lead into the last segment for today. And of course, today's last segment, every Wednesday, we're back on track with Danny's Money with Daniel Baker over there in Korea. He is a senior in high school doing financial podcast segments. So I'm just like so proud of him. He's doing such a great job. He's in his last semester in school. From his updates, he told me, a big congratulations to Daniel. He's already been accepted to 2 universities in America, so super happy about that. He's still waiting on a couple others and for some scholarship news too, so I'll keep you updated, all right? Everyone, please welcome Daniel Baker with Danny's Money.
Hello guys, welcome back to your favorite podcast, Danny's Money. Today is the first topic of 2022. A very interesting topic I brought, and it's going to be a 3-week continuation of a topic that you guys will enjoy. Let's not waste any time, and let's get right into it. Today, we're going to talk about passive income and side hustles. So, before we go into the bread and butter, we need to know what these terms actually mean. First term we need to know is the side hustle. Now, you have your main income, right? You might be working a job, you know, that brings in most of the income. You might be working as an entrepreneur, and that will be your main income. However, what you want to have is something called a side hustle. It is literally something that you do, is a business that you make, or is something profitable, something you can market and make profitable. But it's on the side, so you're not doing your main thing. You don't actually put all of your focus into your main hustle or your main job, but you scatter your attention over many things. So you can focus on your main job, then you can work on your side hustle. Now, why is your side hustle such a good thing? Well, I'll talk about this later in detail, but your side hustle is something you can build on. It's something that will give you extra cash, so you need to do stuff, you know. You need to pay rent, hey, get a side hustle. To recap what I just said, it is a small business that you make and improve over time, of course, that you do on the side. It's not your main thing that you do, but you do it on the side, so as you improve your main job, how you work at your job, you also improve and scatter your time, you know, after work, of course, and use it as your side hustle time. As your side hustle grows, you'll make more money, and you'll expand your business into something maybe in the future you can actually make it as your main income, which is actually pretty fascinating to me, because even if I'm doing YouTube and Twitch. However, those things are not my, you know, main thing I do. It's the main thing I do is, you know, my part-time job plus my schoolwork. However, my side hustle is Twitch and YouTube, which in the future, if they get really big, then, you know, I'm very happy and that can actually be my main job if I wanted it to be like that. Now, there's a type of side hustle you can make that generates passive income. Passive income is the income you make, you know, when you're sleeping, that income grows. Like, let's say you do YouTube. Now, YouTube is such a discoverable place to, you know, make your videos and put videos online. So if you make revenue off of YouTube, then if you post a video, then that video gets more views, more ads. You don't have to actually do more things for that video. You can actually just, you know, while you're sleeping, make more money. That's the thing that's called passive income. Now, it's not your main income. Your main income is your main job. However, you're generating money when as time flows, which is an amazing thing because as time increases, you know, it also grows at the same time. So as I said, through your side hustle, you can actually create passive income if you wanted to. Now, why would you want to create passive income? So as I said, the ultimate goal is to make money when you're sleeping. Now, this doesn't mean it will be easy to do because passive income is such a large thing. It's very hard to motivate people to, you know, buy your stuff, buy your products. And it takes a lot of time and effort to make people buy your product or, you know, watch your videos. So it's not easy to create it, but you need to make something that grows over time. Now, the next question is, why would you want to make a side hustle? Now, side hustles, the best thing about side hustles is that it is supposed to be fun. You're supposed to have fun and enjoy the process. It's the thing that you do on the side. You're using your own free time. No one's paying you to do this at first. So you need to do something, a side hustle, that is actually fun to you, that you're passionate about. Now, because we're a financial podcast, right? I do recommend that you make a side hustle that can make you really good money and has the potential to make really good buck. I deeply recommend that you start a side hustle that you're in a topic that you're deeply interested in. Now, here's the reason why. There are times where you can't sell your products. There's going to be some times where you can't improve, but you need to believe that over time, everything is going to pan out. That over time, the effect of compounding, doing stuff a little bit at a time, will become something great. Now, what is one of the side hustles I'm actually doing? I actually have an online clothing store. Of course, it's in Korea. And it's where I buy used clothing and sell it for a higher price online. And this is using something like the Korean version of Craigslist, which is very interesting because it's more advanced than Craigslist in a way that it's actually very safe to trade on this site. It's more safer. There's more regulations and stuff. In this side hustle, there's a lot of factors that are included. There's a lot of shipping fees. There's a lot of price to, yeah, you know, I have to pay a lot of money upfront to buy the clothing. There's a coupon system I'm also thinking about. Everything needs to be fine-tuned for maximum sales. That's how I look at it. Now, you shouldn't just look at success as your goal, but your goal is to enjoy this process of doing your side hustle. Because if you don't enjoy it, you'll eventually burn out and crash and, yeah, you're just going to waste all of that time, right? So do something that you're very passionate in. Even better, do something that you've done from a young age that you're constantly going to do in the future. So today we talked about side hustles and passive income. I hope that this podcast made you think of what kind of side hustle I can make that actually can make really good money in the future. If you're thinking of that, then my goal is achieved. So this was Danny's Money. Hope you guys have a nice day and a nice week with the Lord. Peace out, guys.
And that's a big thank you to Daniel Baker over there in Korea right now. Senior in high school, second gen. I hope you guys really enjoyed his financial segment, Danny's Money. All right. So that leads us to the end of the podcast. Hope you guys really enjoyed today's Wednesday podcast. Have an amazing and awesome Wednesday service tonight. And then we'll see you guys again tomorrow on the Morning Star Drive on 117.8.
It's the Morning Star Drive, 117.8. You soaring up with sky, now's the time, don't delay. I'm sitting in my ride and it's time to fly. So let's realign, just listen and fill your mind.
I'm burning with desire and the passion. Nobody can stop me when I'm like this. I got my head in the zone, you know. I'm on the Morning Star Drive, you know. I'm burning with desire and the passion. Nobody can stop me when I'm